Hey, what is going on, guys? Tyler here with Secure Team. Thank you for stopping by. We've got a lot of stuff to talk about today, ranging from space to a very eerie video that came from the Pentagon that was recently published and made public after a Freedom of Information request, and we'll show you that and talk about it in just a second. But first, I thought we'd start off mentioning the recent death of a fellow UFO researcher, which we actually did a video on back in July when he originally passed away. And there's a lot of new reports just now hitting the web over the past couple of days, sort of bringing this story back into the spotlight. But if you remember back in July, we posted a video where we were talking about two UFO researchers who had mysteriously passed away in the same month. The first of which was Max Spears, whose death is back in the spotlight over the past couple of days. The second being a man by the name of Gaurav Tiwari, who was a native of India and was also found dead under mysterious circumstances and has since been ruled a suicide, although apparently a lot of his family members don't buy that. So when I originally posted that video back in July, we really didn't have any, well, not much details about the death of Max Spears, who was an up-and-coming UFO researcher and who was found dead under mysterious circumstances in an apartment in Poland. And that's pretty much all we knew. These new reports that have come out, which have provided some information that we didn't have before, in the form of a cell phone text that was sent from Max to his mother, stating, and I quote, "Your boy's in trouble. If anything happens to me, investigate." So a father of two was found dead on a sofa days before he was scheduled to give a talk about his research, UFOs, and conspiracy theories. He was in Poland, where he had been invited to speak at a conference. He was originally from Canterbury and lived here in the United States for a few years. He had returned to his home city to stay with his mother just before leaving for Poland. His family members have stated that he was making a name for himself in the world of conspiracy theorists and this research that we do. And in Poland, he was, quote, "staying with a woman that he didn't know for very long when they found him dead on a sofa to, quote, natural causes." And so his mother received this very strange, eerie text message, specifically saying, "I'm in trouble. If anything happens to me, investigate," which I think is very telling, and it's very sad. The whole situation is just sad, and his family do not believe that this young man, a very healthy, athletic man, would just drop dead, laying on a couch, and just die. They definitely think he was digging into some dark places, including that of some very popular political figures and whatnot. And the police apparently have ruled that he died from natural causes despite there being no post-mortem examination that was carried out. So, you know, how can you say that he died of natural causes if you have not even done a post-death autopsy? So we have this unexplained death, the subsequent treatment by authorities, all of it which is sparking controversy, questions by many people, both family of the victim as well as people like us and others all over the web. Yeah, we have this cryptic new text message, and it's just disconcerting. Feeling, you know, sort of a pain in the pit of your stomach reading a text like that and then finding out that the man passed away just days later. It's not the first time a ufologist or a researcher into a taboo subject like this has been found deceased under extremely suspicious circumstances. I guess we'll never really know the truth, but yeah, we will follow this. You know, you gotta be careful. I mean, who knows what this guy was into? There's a lot of powerful entities out there who do not want people like Max or me or any of the other thousands of researchers out there nosing around in their business, in things that they shouldn't be nosing around in. And yeah, we will continue to follow this. So, sad day, you know, what are you going to do? Now, We have a very interesting piece of UFO footage that was just sent over by a viewer capturing a UFO that seems to be hovering outside of the International Space Station, which looks to do some very fast maneuvers, moving one direction, turning, and then jetting off into space. So I'll let you watch the clip, and then we'll break it down in just a second. So check this out. All right, so immediately when the clip starts, you'll notice this white object in the distance, right near the solar panel. You can see it. It almost has sort of a saucer-like shape to it. We will go ahead and zoom in here, and I want you to notice how immediately the cameraman goes to pan the camera away. And as he does that, we see the UFO jet to the right, then jet to the left, and then you see it pass back behind the Soyuz and then fly off in the distance. So we are looping this over, and look at this. Look at this thing fly off. It flies off, it flies backwards, is what you're seeing. It flies backwards, turns, it makes a complete 180, goes back the other way, curves around, and we see it coming back into view from behind the Soyuz, jetting out into space, getting smaller and smaller. This is an amazing piece of footage. I mean, you guys just watch it. And this is from the live stream, the International Space Station live stream. Here's the still image of this object, which we see sort of sitting there. We will go ahead and zoom in here up close to the object. We're going to go frame by frame here just to show you that this object is in the distance and it does go behind the spacecraft, turns, and then jets off. So let's go frame by frame. And you can see it turning even. You can actually see definition to this object. I see it looks like it has an arm protruding from it. It definitely has a shape, and you can definitely see it turning. Here we see it momentarily goes behind the spacecraft, stops, goes back the opposite way. Loops back and curves back around, goes back behind the capsule, where once again we see it come back into view, jetting off into space, getting smaller and smaller, going behind the solar panel until it is gone. I mean, boom, you know, you're busted. So, great piece of footage. It speaks for itself. And this is probably one of the best ISS captures I've seen, because not only do we see the object, we see it maneuvering, we see it passing by, changing directions, and then we see it jetting off into the distance, which definitely would indicate that this is under an intelligent control. We have seen these objects shadowing the space station, watching, and we actually have another clip that was taken a little bit later during this spacewalk where we see another faint white object in the distance. Could it be the same object? I'm not sure. Here is that video here, and it happens very quickly. Okay, so this happens very briefly, and before the camera is completely cut away and positioned so we can no longer see this object in the background, but it's definitely there, as you can see. And at one point, you can even see a reflection in the mirror on the astronaut's arm here, which I'm not sure if that is a reflection of the object that's behind him. It looks strange due to the direction that the mirror is facing. I would think that whatever is being reflected in it would be being reflected from the right of the astronaut, whereas this other white object that we're looking at is behind the astronaut. And, you know, could this be the moon? I'm not so sure, because it looks awfully small. I mean, it does not look like the moon. You know, it's just it's one of those things where we'll just kind of let you guys decide. But one thing we do know is that we have this object jetting off. So big thanks to Kosa Gary for sending this in. You got an eagle eye, man. I really appreciate it. Let me know what you guys think. Some pretty damning footage. Now, onto this very mysterious dystopian Pentagon video that's just been released. And this was actually first reported by TheIntercept.com, entitled Pentagon Video Warns of Unavoidable Dystopian Future for World's Biggest Cities. And the video was obtained by The Intercept after a Freedom of Information request, where like it shows like a world, a dystopian world filled with these urban hellscapes, they're calling them, where you have these brutal, anarchy-filled super cities that are filled with gangs and youth gone wild, criminal syndicates, and it's a scenario that is all outlined in the title of the video, which is called, quote, Megacities, Urban Future, The Emerging Complexity. And it's a 5-minute video that was used at the Pentagon's Joint Special Operations University. Now, I will put the link to the article down here in the video description. You can head over and watch the video. But apparently the video was used as a quote, advanced special operations combating terrorism course, which is used to prepare special operations forces to, quote, shape the future strategic environment by providing specialized joint professional military education. And it just talks about how the Army is completely unprepared for the future of our planet, where these megacities, presumably New York City, cities in Brazil, which are already being plagued with crime and are being completely controlled by these syndicates, and how this is likely going to be the future that we are going to live in. It's like we're all going to be fending for ourselves, according to the video. In the narrator of the video. So it's just a very, again, disconcerting video. And according to the U.S. military, this is, quote, the world of our future. Going on to say, it is one that we are not prepared to effectively operate within, and it is unavoidable. The threat is clear. Our direction remains to be defined. The future is urban. So, basically, yeah, the gist of it is that, according to the military, these urban areas with a population of 10 million or more are going to be eventually turned into these megacity slums, you know, ruled by crime lords and gangs, and the Army is just completely unequipped to deal with it. So, again, it's all very strange. The video is strange, and, you know, this is what they're showing their recruits and their special operators, as they're called, and yeah, it's just all very unsettling, I guess is the word. So check out that article from The Intercept, watch the video, and yeah, let me know what you guys think. I'd really like to know. Strange stuff. Now, before we end today's video, we have some new space news, the first of which, on a lighter note, is the Mars landing of the European spacecraft known as the Schiaparelli module, which initiated its descent yesterday on the 16th, where it detached from its mothership, I guess you could call it, the Trace Gas Orbiter, at about 10:42 a.m. EDT. And these were a part of the ESA and Russian ExoMars mission. And this is the first phase of the ExoMars project that is aimed at searching for signs of life that existed on Mars in the past. That's what this probe is going to be checking on. And now, this is not a rover. However, a second mission, which will come about in 2020, is when they are going to land the ExoMars rover that will move about on the Martian surface, much like our rovers here, compliments of NASA. So, the search continues. I'm glad that we have other space agencies getting into the fight here. You know, hopefully we'll be able to depend on them. Hopefully. I'm crossing my fingers, but, you know, I'm not getting my hopes up. But hopefully they will be a little bit more transparent. And if they do find something there, they will publish it immediately to the public and not dance around it. So, exciting news. And while we're on the topic of going into space, visiting other planets and whatnot, many of you guys have probably heard of this. There is a new, quote, space nation out in space that you today can become a citizen of, and it's called Asgardia, and it is the first ever nation in space, or nation state, as they're calling it. So a team of scientists and legal experts got together, and they created the Asgardia Project as an attempt to create a nation founded on peace in space and the prevention of Earth's conflicts being transferred into space. So the idea is to create a mirror of humanity in space. And although this is actually not like a real space station, it's just like a little tiny orbiter. Despite that, millions of people have already signed up on the website to become the new country's citizens, and anyone can join. Now, the next step will be for them to launch their first satellite in 2017, which will become its first outpost in space. And while, you know, its citizens will still be Earthbound, it says that, I quote, a space station will eventually follow. You're seeing an artist's rendition of the possible space station that we will likely see sometime in the future. And so, this new country will be democratic, but not ruled by earthly laws or the existing space laws. Its founders envision the need for a new universal space law and, quote, astropolitics. So, pretty cool idea, you know? You can go and sign up and officially become a citizen of a space nation, which in and of itself is just a pretty cool thing to be able to tell your friends or maybe use as a pickup line when you're hitting on a girl in a bar or something. I mean, what woman could turn you down after admitting that you're a citizen of a newly created space nation? I mean, I would think it would be a done deal. So, I'll put the article to this and the website down below. Let me know what you guys think. And you know what? Go ahead over and join the nation. All right? And let me know what you guys think about everything we've talked about today. Some strange stuff, definitely. Definitely some strange topics. I want to hear your thoughts. Be sure to let me know. And if you have any footage or stories you want me to talk about, be sure to shoot me an email. My email's in the video description. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And I'll see you back real soon. All right, so thanks for stopping by, and stay safe.